Hi, YouTube. Thank you for the very warm welcome back. It feels good. Feels good to be here. Feels good to know that you're as excited as I am about this. So this is a video, Cicada Mania. It's one that I made as part of a mini series called Art Lab. And I made and posted this video back in 2021. So if you didn't see that when it was first posted on my personal channel, here it is now to tide you over while I'm making new videos. Also, if you sign up for my Patreon, I'm giving everybody free shipping on all print orders. So it's a great way of supporting me and the channel's relaunch. And also you can support an artist during the holidays and give a little piece of art that I will sign and send with a little thank you note to show my appreciation. Also this month, for the first time, I'm going to do a painting live stream for my patrons. So if you sign up for my Patreon this month, also you get access to the live stream I'm gonna do and more details on that to be announced. I'm gonna be filming an Ask Emily video to answer some of your, if not all of your burning questions. I can't answer all of your burning questions. Some of those you just need to Google. But I will do an Ask Emily video, so stay tuned for that. And also, I got back from Vienna, Austria recently, so I have some cool footage from running around the exhibits there for a few days, and in addition to a lot of other cool videos that I'm working on, because the announcement of the show coming back was very enthusiastic. So I cannot wait to have more new content for you soon, but in the meantime, enjoy!
There's a rhythm to the cycles of life, and we humans love to bond over them, from the changing seasons to the birth, life, and death of our loved ones. Through these ideas, we can connect with people and things that seem more distantly related to us than maybe they really are. I mean, I've often wondered what I could possibly have in common with a 4th century imperial Chinese ruler, but what if I told you it was a mutual interest in insects?
Hi, I'm Emily Grassley, and welcome to my art lab, where we will be celebrating two of my favorite things, art and science, and how they come together, and all the amazing things that happen when they intersect. I'm very excited about this. It is our first episode, brand new project, super pumped. Normally I would have like a party popper or something, but I already used them up. Yay! Oh. I'm very excited. I just wish I had more party poppers.
There's something on my face. I have a feeling there's something on my face. Hey, so.
So, spring 2021 was a huge, big deal for bug nerds interested in seeing one of the greatest natural phenomenons on our planet. Lots of people were talking about something called the Brood 10 cicada emergence. It marked a special time when parts of the eastern United States became awash in the collective sound of billions of insects all trying to attract a mate at the same time. It was a very noisy affair. You probably couldn't have missed it if you tried. But cicadas can be found around the world, and people have been fascinated with these loud, bug-eyed insects for thousands of years. Even Homer's Iliad, dated around 700 BC, talks of cicadas. They sat there on the tower, these Trojan elders, like cicadas perched up on a forest branch, chirping soft, delicate sounds. And other classical poets wrote odes to cicadas, too. A 1st century BC Syrian Greek poet, Meleager of Gadara, wrote, "O shrill-voiced insect, that with dewdrops sweet inebriate, dost in the desert woodland sing."
Not sure if I know what that one means.
So the question is, why? Well, it has to do with the cicada's unique life cycle. Some species live abnormally long lives, up to 17 years. The vast majority of that time is spent underground, sucking the sap out of tree roots before they emerge suddenly in huge numbers, make a ton of noise, mate profusely, and then die within a couple weeks. So, for people like the ancient Greeks, this remarkable story of death and rebirth was inspirational. The cicada's loud, buzzing songs evoked poetry-worthy ideas about love and passion. And as well as in ancient Chinese cultures, cicadas represented purity. They subsist on dew and perch high in trees, essentially living an aspirational life, eating well, and living the high life. But humans' interest in these insects goes back even further, up to 4,000 years ago. Carved jade pendants of cicadas have been found in ancient Chinese tombs, where they were placed on the tongue of the deceased as a gesture of hope for rebirth and immortality. It's a practice that lasted a few thousand years and existed as late as the Han Dynasty, around 200 BC to 200 AD.
During that time, cicadas also played an important role in court costume, appearing in gold plaques worn on imperial headdresses. But historically, this love for the cicada has not been universal. In Western cultures, and those rooted in biblical traditions, insects have had negative connotations as detestable, creepy, swarming creatures. But in East Asian traditions, insects have had a far more favorable reception. In the mid-1700s, Japanese artist Kitagawa Utamaro produced a book of 15 insect-themed illustrations accompanied by poems from various authors in his book Ihan Mushi Arami, or Picture Book of Crawling Creatures. For the poem about the cicada, poet Hayakisai Morikado wrote, "Evening cicada, is it you who steals the right moment to fly into another's arms? But you cry constantly, like a poor soul living one day at a time." Japanese art and culture took hold in Europe in the late 1800s, and a new appreciation for insects, at least in art, soon followed. The Art Nouveau movement capitalized on nature motifs, and French designers like Maurice Piard-Vernoy released portfolios bursting with everything from chickens to butterflies and, you got it, cicadas. Today, cicada mania persists. Emerging contemporary artists celebrate them, like Cassidy Post in her installation Changing Room, which she says was influenced by the transformative experience of COVID-19 and the natural cycles of life. Artists like Nobuo Nagasawa create large-scale artwork inspired by cicadas too. Here she stenciled them onto the plywood boards used to protect a storefront in New York during the 2020 George Floyd protests. As symbols of hope and rejuvenation, the cicadas represent themes of resilience and survival. But you really don't have to look very hard to see just how influential cicadas are to the art and craft-making process. Just a quick search of the cicada hashtag on Instagram delivers paintings and illustrations, coffee mug designs, cicada stained glass, cross stitch, jewelry, pottery, stickers, an impressive assortment of cicada themed tattoos. Some artists even use masses of shed cicada skeletons to make some rather interesting sculptural works that definitely elicit a visceral response. They're very cool. They're really well done. I'm incredibly impressed. They just kind of make my stomach hurt. Even me, I was inspired. I made this. I'm on board. I'm Team Cicada for sure. I got them on my clothes. I got them on my ears. I got them on my coffee mug. It's Cicada Mania here, right here today. Just me in my house, yelling about cicadas by myself. So after all of this talk and research, the anticipation to find the Brood 10 cicadas has been growing. I knew I needed to go see them.
Okay, so we are here at Indiana University's Research and Teaching Lab outside of campus. I'm here with Emmy, who is a graduate student at the university. We are here to see the 17-year periodical cicadas, which I've literally been waiting for 17 years to see. They are emerging here in huge numbers, millions, maybe even billions of them coming out across the country, and we are here to see them today. I'm so pumped. There's actually more than 3,000 species of cicadas that live all over the world, and they are kind of categorized in different groups. So there are annual cicadas, which emerge every year, and then there are periodical cicadas, and they're grouped into two different kinds. There's the 13-year periodical cicadas. They emerge every 13 years, and the 17-year periodical cicadas. And of those different groups, there are also different broods, because some of them emerge in different parts of the country. It's all a huge, complicated thing that nature has figured out. The point being, these guys are part of Brood 10, which is the most widespread and abundant of all of the periodical cicadas. So when I say this is a one in every 17 year opportunity, I mean it. I mean, I drove 3.5 hours down here to see this, and I couldn't be more excited or more covered with bugs. I have them in my shirt, I have them in my hair, they are everywhere, and I have no regrets. So if you stand in place long enough, pretty soon you're probably gonna be covered in cicadas. And it's not just because they want to be all over you, it's actually programmed in their DNA. So when these cicadas emerge and after they have shed their final lymph form, The adults need to breed, and they do so in trees. So there's actually a purpose to them wanting to climb all over you, and it's because they want to get up the tree to meet the ladies. That's my assessment. So I knew that there were going to be a lot of cicadas down here, but I don't think I predicted just how many there would be. They are on everything. You can't walk around this forested area without them crawling all over you, flying in your face. You're hearing other people screaming who aren't as excited about the cicadas. And eventually they just get on you. But like, this is amazing. You know, and it makes a lot of sense. They have to emerge in such huge quantities, you know, millions, even billions of individuals in order to survive and pass on their genes. Essentially, what they're trying to do is overwhelm the predators here. And, you know, it's amazing that a lot of these, they're not going to survive. They probably won't live to mate, but enough of them will. And that's the strategy. And it works. And in the meantime, we get to be around so many bugs. There are so many. You know, I was leaning down here to get some footage, and you just sort of get this waft of death and decay because they're here in such amazingly abundant numbers. But even the huge number of their decomposing bodies provides nutrients to these trees.
The cicada's life cycle works like this. A mother cicada lays her eggs, like 500 of them, in a tree branch where they grow for 6 to 10 weeks before hatching. Then they promptly drop and burrow underground, where they latch onto a tree root and begin drinking its sap. And this is where the baby cicada will remain, slowly growing for 17 years. When the time comes, they dig themselves out, head up to the nearest vertical surface, and are ready to fully transform into adults. The process is a little bit creepy. They bust out the back of their exoskeletons, leaving the empty husks of their former selves in massive numbers on the ground and in trees. When two cicadas make a match, they mate. And within an hour, the female lays her 500 eggs, and then she dies, and her body joins the mass of fellow corpses.
So the other really cool thing about these cicadas is the chorus that they make. I mean, an individual cicada is pretty noisy, but when they all start calling together, it can be overwhelming.
What's incredible is that it's only the males that are singing. Males have a special structure called a timbre. When they flex certain muscles in their abdomen, it creates fast-moving vibrations that produce these distinct and very loud calls.
Some people went out with a decibel monitor to see just how loud they get and recorded some huge cacophonies like this, and these cicadas collectively can reach up to 90 decibels. That is louder than a lawnmower. It's impressive. I mean, you have a hard time even hearing yourself think sometimes, but it's pretty incredible that nature can make such an awesome sound. Good job, guys. It's a symphony of insects screaming. Just music to my ears. I mean, what do you think we've learned today?
I think we've learned that the cicadas are everywhere. They think that we're trees, and yeah. They are awesome.
Yeah. Yeah. Was this, what would you say today was a success?
Today was absolutely a success. We saw so many cicadas.
It was pretty awesome. I don't know what I was expecting, but this blew it out of the water.
I'm so glad.
Oh, this is amazing. This is one of the coolest things I've ever done. No regrets. Thank you so much for showing me around today. This is awesome.
Thank you for coming. This was great.
Awesome.
All right, that does it for me today. I just want to say thank you so much for watching, and thanks to the Described and Captioned Media Program for supporting Art Lab. The DCMP provides premium accessible media for students with disabilities. If you want to know more, head on over to their website. And if you would like to support Art Lab, check us out on Patreon. A little bit goes a long way, and I would sincerely appreciate it. You can like and subscribe, tell your friends, and I will see you next time.
It still has brains on it.